I trained as a primary care physician, taking care of individual patients one by one. But I realized at a certain point that if we don't take care of people's habitat, if people don't have good places to live, they can't thrive. Every zookeeper realizes this. The first thing you think about as a zookeeper is, how do I create good habitat for the animals so that they can thrive? We need to think about humans the same way. And we need to think about that on the very big scale of populations. That means that if there's a force threatening people's habitats, our collective world, then we need to address that force. That means we need to address climate change to create a world in which we and our children and our grandchildren can thrive.
I really believe that if you get the best scientists around the world together, working on the best evidence, using that as a platform for advocacy and activism and not being frightened to do so, I think then you have an instrument that can really not only shape policy but actually trigger political transformation. And that's what we're trying to do here. We are trying to change the consciousness of a generation of political leaders and policymakers using science as the basis for that social change.
I think about our energy systems. The energy systems around the world are not only the predominant source of greenhouse gas emissions, they're also the source of all types of other types of air pollution that harm our health. And so when we look at those systems, we have technologies today that we can be putting out there today and deploying today that will protect human health not only in the short term by reducing air pollution, but in the longer term by mitigating these impacts. So the response is to upgrade and update our energy systems to be cleaner, and then do that as quickly as possible so that we can really reap these benefits.
I think it's important to realize that as a scientist or we scientists, we need to come up with new forms to communicate. So it's not only about publishing papers, and it's not only about talking to one another as in other academics or scientists, but other ways of making sure that we send our message through. Because we are on the front lines and we see what happens and we know our facts, but sometimes there might be a gap in how we manage to get our messages through. So maybe look into new ways of communicating. So one of the things that I did was that instead of only publishing papers, I make photo films. So I let my informants tell their own stories to the world. And I'm sure that if you compare a paper that I've published and that tiny documentary of 2.5 minutes, more people are gonna understand my key points from the paper through that video than actually by reading the paper.